with me during this period. And she was bedridden, I think, because of chikungunya for 3 months. And even now she cannot drive a car. And she finds it very difficult to walk. In spite of best of treatment, there is lot of suffering because of chikungunya. Though we think it's a small viral disease, but the morbidity is much higher than the mortality. So I thought, because this was there in my mind, that's what I told Dr. Vikas, that let me, you know, give you some aspects of these diseases which are very important, as all of us are suffering from these diseases, whether it is us or our family members. We are suffering from these diseases day in and day out, you know. So we need to have a knowledge of these diseases, how these diseases are being transmitted, what is the agent which is causing the diseases, and what best we can do to protect ourselves so that we don't get these infections and suffer from these diseases. So that is why and we are able to protect ourselves. We have good clothes, we can protect ourselves from the bite of these mosquitoes. But who is actually suffering from this disease? It is the poor people who are suffering from this disease, because they do not have good housing, they do not have proper clothes, they have to, you know, sleep outside and so on. So all the more, it is our responsibility to, you know, protect them so that they do not, then they do not have access. See, if we fall sick, we have access to the hospital, we have access to the health facility, immediately we get the help from a doctor, we can get admitted. But these poor people, first of all, if they live in villages, they do not have access to the health facility. And moreover, even if they are living in the urban areas, they are living in some shanty, you know, kind of a places, where then they do not have money to, you know, afford the treatment of when they get sick. So all the more, it is very important to learn the different types of diseases. Like, you must have heard of common diseases like malaria, kala azar, this dengue, chikungunya, Japanese encephalitis. So all these are transmitted by the vectors, and it is very easy, you know, to protect yourself from these diseases. So it should be because there is so much of morbidity as well as mortality from these diseases, it should be a global health agenda that we should protect our community world over, you know. It is not in one country, world over this agenda should be there, that we should try to protect our community from these diseases by adopting some simple measures. So that is the main aim, that is why I had put the global health agenda. It should be world over, it should be there. Because initially these diseases were restricted to some areas of the world. But slowly, you know, because of globalization, urbanization, movement of, you know, so much travel is there nowadays. So these are the arthropods, and especially the insects. Especially you have the mosquitoes, you have ticks as well as the bugs. So all these, you know, insects, we call them as vectors, who are transmitting these pathogens. Now the pathogen can be a bacteria, pathogen can be a virus, pathogen can be a parasite. So anything that is transmitted by these vector, we call that as a vector. And these diseases which are caused by the vectors, we call them as vector-borne diseases. Now there can be two types of transmission. One is the biological, another is the mechanical transmission. When we say of biological transmission, it means that whenever the vector bites, you know, it sucks blood. Yes. So anybody knows why the vector sucks blood? Anybody? Everybody will know. Why the mosquito? Shauk hai usko katne ka? Come on.
For legs.
I will be concentrating more on the public aspect of it, how important this topic is. I hope I will be able to justify. So, when Dr. Vikas asked me, what kind of lecture I'll deliver. I thought nowadays we are facing a big challenge of these vector-borne diseases. Especially, you must have seen that last some 2-3 months back, you must also have seen in your family, we also noticed many people suffering from dengue, chikungunya, isn't it?
Yes,
you must have seen everybody in the family, I think, in everybody's family, one person or the other, must have suffered from dengue and chikungunya. And I also noticed in the university itself, some of our close friends, they suffered from chikungunya especially. There was much rise in the incidence of chikungunya. And more than the, you know, disease, we think that chikungunya and mosquito bites, you get the infection. But though it is not a kind of a disease which causes mortality, but it causes lot of morbidity. One of our fellows, I will not name her, but she had chikungunya.